No, absolutely. And I mean, we're might as well start talking about the Magic, seeing as they're up next here at number six. But talk about a team that's got a lot of high-end potential, but like you say, just seems to be throwing names in a blender and hoping that something comes of it. Like even their point guard situation, it's like, are you going to commit to Suggs or are you going to commit to Anthony? Right? Like they internally don't even really know which direction they want to lean, because both of those players bring very different things to the table. And so I was half expecting to see one of them moved at the draft and either packaged with something to move up or possibly, go and acquire, maybe a forward or a shooter or something like that. But I mean, the person that they probably could have used, if this is the team that they're actually going to roll with moving forward, right, was probably Grady Dick out of Kansas, who the Raptors ultimately ended up selecting at 13th overall, which, I mean, we'll touch on the Raps in a little bit, but like you said, they need some bodies to space the floor a little bit if this truly is the roster that they're going to roll into opening night with. So do they have more moves up their sleeve? I don't know, but if this is kind of the depth chart that they plan to deploy, I don't know how much improved they are from last year's version of this team.
Yeah, I mean, taking Black at six just like cramps their floor even more. And then they had a chance to take Grady Dick at 11, and they decided to go with Jett Howard, who, like, honestly, I like Jett Howard. I think he's going to be a nice player, but Grady Dick's a better shooter. I mean, Howard's a good shooter, but Dick is better. So, like, it seems like a poor draft by them yet again. It's just a weird fit.
Well, that's right. Anthony Black, a larger point guard, right? He's got some heft to him, we'll say. And so now it really is like, guess what? You've got three talented guards here. Only one of them can have the ball in their hands at any given moment, right? And if you truly want to have this kind of positionless offense, that only works when you have shooters, which they don't have, right? Like they either have guards or kind of slower bigs, and they don't have a whole lot of, wings that can really attack. Like Paolo, that's a lot of their offense is going to be running through him for obvious reasons. But how, at a certain point, now that you've got a year of film on him, is the opposing defenders starting gonna pick up on some tendencies here, and it's gonna be a little bit more of a sophomore slump and tougher for him to get to the basket because you've now got opposing defenders starting to lock in on him? I don't know. It's just one of those picks that it only makes sense if there's a future move coming down the road, and whether that's shipping Suggs out of town, whether Cole Anthony is getting moved, something's got to give, because as you said, there's a bit of a log jam there at this point now at the guard position.
Yeah, no, absolutely.